Member for Coquitlam, Millardville.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Well, yesterday the Minister of Health said in this House that he takes the Seniors Advocate's recommendations seriously. Well, 12 months ago, the Seniors Advocate released a report, Placement, Drugs and Therapy, We Can Do Better. The report documents findings of a high-level review of health assessment records of BC's 25,000 seniors in residential care and 29,000 seniors receiving home care. She noted that while 47% of residential care clients are being prescribed antidepressant medication, only 24% of these clients have actually been diagnosed with depression. So this data released a year ago, tells us that we are continuing to drug our seniors unnecessarily. Can the minister tell us why he's continuing to fail these seniors?
Minister of Health.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Thank you, Honourable Speaker. I note that the member didn't take the opportunity to correct the record from her misstatements yesterday in terms of the cooperation that all health authorities have had with the seniors advocate. Honourable Speaker, the reality is that this has been recognized across Canada, but I would say that every one of those prescriptions is prescribed by a physician, not a critic who doesn't know the information from which he reads, Honourable Speaker, doesn't take the opportunity to do research to make sure the information she has is correct. But on, Honourable Speaker, we recognize and we are working with the doctors of BC, we are working with care providers and health authorities, with the BC Patient and Safety Quality Council to ensure that we have appropriate prescription and dispensing of medications to seniors, Honourable Speaker, and we have programs that are working to reduce the unnecessary medication in residential care homes.
On a supplemental.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Well, I think it's important to recognize that this minister knows full well that the reason for over-medicating seniors is that there's not enough hands to support these frail and elderly seniors. They need more people, and this government isn't providing it. Honourable Speaker, this past September, over 6 months ago, the Seniors Advocate released a report called Caregivers in Distress, More Respite Needed. In that report, the advocate notes that 29% of caregivers are in distress, one of the highest reported in this country. She goes on to note, and I quote, services such as home support have not kept pace with the increase in the seniors population. If the minister really takes the advocate's recommendation seriously, can he tell us why this government has provided almost $1 billion in tax relief to the province's wealthiest, while our seniors and their caregivers, the people who have built this province, why they have to continue to suffer?
Minister of Health.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Maybe, Honourable Speaker, maybe the member should look to her left and ask her colleague why, as Chief of Staff, he cut residential care spaces, cut home services. Honourable Speaker, everyone has seen the wave of demographics coming at us, and that is why we created the Office of the Seniors Advocate. That is why we work with health authorities and the Office of the Seniors Advocate. Honourable Speaker, we have made record investments in residential care, in assisted living, in group homes around the province. And the members opposite know that. They know what the situation was like in the 1990s. They know how much better it is today. We will continue to improve services for seniors who have built the province of British Columbia.